a best-selling author and resident foodie on QVC, and today he is back to prepare a delicious French toast casserole that is perfect for Christmas morning, or really all year long. So say hello to David Venable.
Hello there, my friend. Nice to see you.
Oh my gosh, it's so good to have you.
I'm so thrilled to be back.
I know, it's so fun. And Debbie is at the counter, joined by Kim and Ellie.
Hi, guys. Good to see you all again. I know she's over there sipping the syrup. She's ready to roll.
Yeah.
Can you smell the smell in here? It smells like Christmas in here.
Well, you know, Christmas is such a special time of year, and I'm so glad we get to celebrate it in July. But, you know, we love this whole recipe of coming out of summer for just a couple of days and experiencing that chill in the air and all the great foods we love at Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a great dish that I love to make on Christmas Eve.
Okay.
Now, you make this ahead of time, park it in the fridge overnight, and then when Christmas morning comes, because Santa's been there, right?
Yeah.
And everybody's crazy and the kids are wild and everyone's ripping open packages, just pop this in the oven.
Oh, that's so smart.
And then the whole house smells like Christmas while you're having Christmas.
Nice.
And then when all the mayhem settles in the living room, you come into the kitchen and everybody has breakfast. Right?
Win-win. Oh my gosh, this is giving me all the warm and fuzzies inside. Okay, and this feeds a crowd.
I mean, 6 to 8 easily, and if you're making smaller portions, even more. So if you've got the in-laws and the outlaws, come on, we all have them. This is what it's all about. So you're going to be able to do that easily. Now, what we've done first is we've whisked eggs inside here, and then I'm adding eggnog. Why? Because it's Christmas.
Ooh.
Yeah, hello. Yes. So we're going to do that, and I love that. I call this no calorie left behind French toast. Because if you're going to indulge, let's do it on Christmas Day, right?
Why not?
Come on. So some whole milk goes in.
And just go for it.
Then sugar.
Oh, yum.
Little salt for balance.
Of course.
Then cinnamon and nutmeg.
Ugh. These flavors, eggnog, cinnamon, nutmeg. I mean,
it's all Christmas.
Christmas.
And then buy the good vanilla. You know the kind that's made in Madagascar. Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
The bourbon vanilla. Really, really good. And then, if you'll help me with a little whisk here.
Okay.
And get that all whisked together.
I want to get.
Well, a little secret for whisking. I'll give you a little secret for whisking.
What am I doing
Small
wrong?
Small turns in the middle.
Oh. Ooh.
Pulls in the dry ingredients, and that way you don't end up wearing them.
Well, thank you.
How about that? And then you can do a little bit of this, too, to kind of bring it in.
I learned something new from you. I love that.
No worries.
So we've got our egg mixture here, and then over on the side in this pan is day-old bread?
Yeah, this is the easy part. I'll buy a French loaf. I like to leave it out for a day, get it nice and crispy.
Yeah.
Slice this up and layer it in a 9x13. We've already buttered this with some room temperature butter. And then what we're going to do is just pour the mixture over the bread. Now, the reason you do this Christmas Eve is because it needs to soak into all that bread. And the reason I use day-old is because it soaks it up better. It doesn't become so mushy, right?
You could use any sort of bread.
You could use challah.
Challah.
Yeah, get some challah because challah is an egg bread.
Yes.
Challah is an egg bread, so it's even better because it'll be even richer, right?
Oh my
Now, pop this into the fridge overnight. If you don't have overnight, 4 to 6 hours is fine. So what we've already done, Miss Allie, through the magic
of
television, we've got one already soaked.
Yes.
Now we're going to make the topping to go on this.
All right.
So that goes into the fridge. Now the topping is also delightful.
And what we're going to do here. Calorie left behind.
Correct. The theme working here. All right. So we have brown sugar in the bowl, light brown sugar, chopped pecans.
Oh, healthy.
Yeah, right. The only healthy thing. Yeah. And then we're going to put in some room temperature butter.
Low fat butter. Yeah.
Just a little bit. Do you like butter or French toast with your butter?
Right.
And then a little white corn syrup.
Oh, interesting.
Ooh, why that?
This helps bind it together.
Nice.
Yeah. Then from there, again, cinnamon, nutmeg.
And again, you probably could use different nuts, but I mean, pecans really, I feel like, also scream Christmas. Yeah.
Yes. And then we get in here and we give this a little turn.
Look at that.
And it turns into almost like a streusel topping.
Yeah.
Because the butter reacts with the brown sugar. And then we're going to top the casserole with this before it goes in the oven.
Oh, my
God. So while you do that, last time you were here, we were celebrating the release of your third book, Food Shortcuts, which I absolutely love. Will you remind everybody the concept of that book?
Well, the book is all about you're celebrating the idea that not everything has to be made from scratch, right? Can you help me with
yes,
this?
Yes, please.
Just to do a little topping here? Mm-hmm. And you need to, you're sweet with your tool. I want you to use your hands. Again, with your hands. We promise to give you. We're going to give you a towel, I promise. The book is all about 10 ingredients or less, supermarket shortcuts with prepackaged ingredients to get you to the finish line faster. So great food on the table for your family in less time.
That's right. And now this isn't in there, but this is one of the thousands of recipes you do have online.
Right. This is one of the recipes that I've done online that's been a customer favorite at QVC. So we're super excited that we got this one. I'm going to park this into the oven. We already have one finished, so I hope you guys are hungry.
How long would it take?
Now this goes into a 350 oven. For about 35 to 45 minutes.
Perfect. Okay. Time to open all your presents.
Correct. and to find the batteries for the things that you didn't realize you needed batteries for.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Isn't that pretty? Now, before you serve it, you can actually garnish this with maraschino cherries and make these look like holly berries.
No.
Oh, that's sweet.
Now, only at Christmas time. Right now, we couldn't find them this time of year, but you actually can buy green maraschino cherries at Christmas time. So you can do red and green. Isn't that fun? So why don't we go ahead and serve this up?
Let's do it. Oh my goodness.
It looks beautiful.
I love the smell. I mean, I feel like we need to make a candle scent out of this dish right here.
That'd be great.
And you know, I think it's time for you to do another cookbook, my friend.
You know what? I've already got some ideas on what I think I might do. I think I might do desserts next, which I think would be a lot of fun.
Thank you, Allie.
Sorry, I'll
just All right, we need
you have
one
to
more.
Throw the manners outside the window, Allie.
And you have syrup to put over it, too.
Yes.
Which just
and I'll give you a little tip. Warm that syrup because it'll pour faster and it'll be a little nicer. Allie, this is for you.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much.
Forgive my fingers, but they're clean.
All right, David, Allie, you guys get in there. Take a bite of this.
Talk to me and see what you think.
This is the best present anyone would get on Christmas morning.
It's really, really great. And so much fun for Christmas and Christmas in July. You want to do a little test run, you can do it now.
Okay. Yeah.
That's what always doing. Easy, right?
Yes, David.
I'm going in.
Isn't that nice? You think your kids might like this?
You guys go in.
My kids would love it. My kids would go crazy.
You can find the full recipe on HallmarkChannel.com and check your local listings to catch even more recipes on In the Kitchen with David. Now,